It seems to be an established fact that background can't be avoided. Or is this a myth that now ought to be busted? First, we need to understand where background comes from. Background in an immunoprecipitation experiment is caused primarily by two sources. When you use a separation method that is based on slurry as the solid phase, then you need to carefully pipette off and remove all washing buffer after each centrifugation step. If you are using Sepharose or Agarose slurry, one of the problems you come across is that this slurry doesn't form a clear pellet. As a consequence, you can end up either accidentally removing some of the slurry, and therefore part of your sample, or leaving some remaining buffer behind, which ultimately contains unwanted proteins that will give rise to unwanted background. The second source of background comes from the porous slurry itself. The porous Sepharose and Agarose means a lot of liquid gets trapped. Unwanted proteins are therefore also trapped within these pores, and even with lots of washing, you run a high risk of ending up with that unwanted background in your final results. So how is this different when you use Dynabeads? Firstly, Dynabeads are magnetic beads that are efficiently pulled to the side of your sample tube when a magnet is applied. With the bead pellet now on the side, removing all the buffer without disturbing or losing your sample is a lot easier. Secondly, Dynabeads have a defined outer surface without all those pores and holes. Consequently, all binding happens on the outer surface with no inner surface to trap any unwanted proteins. So can background be avoided? With Dynabeads, absolutely.
No wonder so many people are moving away from slurry and over to magnetic beads.